Not ones that I'm like, yeah, but I love the brand. I really don't. This is the least. I like this one the least. That's not this type of video. I kind of want to be ranty today. I actually need to put this in my special effects kit because it sucks the life right out of my face. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video where I'm going to bitch about makeup. Because today I am going to chat about my least favorite products of my most favorite brands. And by least favorite, I mean that some are really, really bad. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you kind of want to have fun again with makeup or just fun in general, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, and if you are slightly orcish like me, then subscribe now, because if you subscribe now, the bonus is you are being added to the Halloween event, because I'm starting a Halloween event. This video should go up before Halloween. If it doesn't, I'm still going to start a Halloween event, but then we're maybe going to make it a little bit more Halloweeny, Christmassy. Nightmare Before Christmas. I don't know. It should go up before Halloween though. I hope. Yes, I'm pre-filming. You can play any instrument that you want, and I will also explain the slightly orcish. That means olive, because I am a light warm olive, and that is slightly orcish. Yes. Well, let me tell you first what I have on my eyeballs. On my eyeballs, I have the Age of Opulence palette from Beauty Bay. I always want to say BH Cosmetics from Beauty Bay. I'm filming with it. Yeah, that's it. If that video is online, I will link it. Otherwise, it is coming very, very soon. This is look 2 of 5. Just saying. Okay. This video idea is actually not mine. I got the idea from Ayelika Nykvist, and I will link her channel down below. She did this. She did basically 10 brands or 10 makeup products that she did not really like from brands that she loved. She also did the equivalent of that, and I'm kind of planning that one as well, because I think it's just very, very fun to chat about things. Now, if you are with me a little while longer, you may know my or at least some of my favorite brands. I will not name them all in this video, because I kind of wanted to keep it at 10 products, and I kind of wanted to keep it at products that I really dislike. So, not ones that I'm like, yeah, but I love the brand. I really don't. This is the least. I like this one the least. That's not this type of video. I kind of want to be ranty today. Yes. Okay. And if you like that, well, just, you know, grab a snack, some munchies, something to drink, and get comfy. Yes. So before we start, I kind of want to give a disclaimer. If these are your holy grail favorites, it's nothing against you. It's all personal preference. And I'm sure that there are some products here that work for someone. They just did not work for me. That's the disclaimer I'm going to give. If I dislike your favorite, I don't dislike you. I just have a different preference. Yes, I don't have everything that I'm going to mention. I have some things. If I have it, I will show it to you. So let me go to the side so that if I don't have it, I can put a picture up. Let's start with something that I don't have, and that is from ColourPop. Now, I love ColourPop. As I said, I live in the Netherlands, so if I want ColourPop, I order it from the USA, because it doesn't matter if I order it from the USA or from, I don't know, the UK or whatever. I have to pay import tax anyway. I love ColourPop as a brand. I think they have very, very fun things. I think that especially eyeshadow palettes, it's a very, very good quality. However, there is one palette. I detest that palette. I don't have it anymore. I know that it is a favorite from a lot of people, and I just don't understand it. I just don't understand it, and it's the Good Sport palette. Yeah. Again, I know it's a favorite from a lot of people. The shades, that there were shades in there that were good quality. I have the shade Trooper I pulled out of that palette because I still have that one in my collection. I really did like it. I think that the shimmers were nice. Not spectacular, but nice. But the purples that were in there that I really wanted to play with, they were not good purples. They were so, so dry. They were so patchy. They were... No. No. So, maybe I got a bad one. Maybe it was my skill set then. I don't know. But I just did not like that palette. At all. Except the shade Trooper, which I still have. But yeah. Let's go to the next thing from ColourPop. Because, yeah, they do a lot of things very well, but they also do some things not very well. This is actually, Angelica mentioned this in her video as well, and those are the cream gel pots from ColourPop. Now, I bought the entire gel set. Yeah. Which was a waste of money, because I think I have used some... this is the yellow one. Can I don't know if you can see... Can you see? Maybe if I do it like that. The scrapiness. Because these are so dry. It's I can feel it, I can touch it, but it's very dry and draggy. So I need to scrape some out and I need to add in a Duraline-like substance. I have one from Makeup Revolution, doesn't really matter. And now this one is okay. But honestly, the most were dried out when I got them. I still have them, because there are some colors here that I'm like, oh, I really, really like those. But I actually should go through them and just pick out the ones that I don't mind reviving. For instance, the red one that I have. But yeah, overall, yeah. If you don't mind reviving the product every time that you use it, then go for it. Otherwise... Go for ones that are maybe a little bit more expensive. For instance, the ones from Lethal are really, really good. I hear that the ones from Melt are really, really good. The ones from ColourPop, yeah, not so much. No. Okay, then I'm going to go to Catrice. And from Catrice, I have tried a lot of things from Catrice. And usually, I can make a lot of things work. This product, though... I have another product that just didn't work, but that was it. It just did not really work, and fine, that's fine. It just didn't work for me, but this product, it not only doesn't work for me, I don't think it will work for anyone, and that's this one. That's their One Step Skin Perfector. I actually pulled it out of my declutter basket because I still had it here in-house, and I can show it. So this is... It's like when you take... a bite of a butter stick, and I don't know why you would, but sometimes this just that feeling, that's what it gives on my face as well. It's just let me show you. It's this. So it's a white substance, and then basically when you smear it out, it kind of gets a little bit of the tone of your skin, but it just doesn't do anything. It does not do anything except make my face feel yucky. I have to really, really scrub. It does not even out. It does not hold my makeup on, because if I put makeup on top, it slides around. It's just not a good product. This is a waste of money. If you want a tinted primer from Catrice that is a nice quality, that can... It doesn't work for everyone, but it works for... a heap load of skin tones, because of the way that the product is made. That's the 1 minute face perfector in a pot. That one is way better than this one. No. Catrice has a lot of good products. This ain't one of them. Yes. The next thing that I'm going to go to is from Essence. And I don't have that anymore. And that product was way, way worse even than this one. Because while the Essence one just... It just doesn't work. It's the idea is fun, but it doesn't work at all. This did something with my... This, let me put a picture up. This is from Essence. It's the My Skin Perfector Primer, the matte. They had three colors. They had light, medium and dark. And I was like, ooh, that's interesting. Let me kind of try that. Because I was hoping that it was kind of like the Catrice 1 minute face perfector that I could not get here anymore in store. This though, maybe if you are extremely oily, you will like this. But for me, when I put this on my face, it was almost like it instantly set. It made my face extremely matte. And 20 years older. It was... And I thought maybe I can use it for filming. No. While it looked nice on camera, I detest it with a passion. The feeling that it gave on my skin, because it made my skin feel like I had, I don't know, a tablespoon of product on my face. It was such a bad product. Again, maybe if you're very oily, you will like it. If you're anything less, stay away, run the other way, screaming, it's not worth it at all. And I love Essence. They have a bunch of good products. No.
No.
Then I'm going to go to Makeup Revolution. Now, Makeup Revolution is a brand that I think you either love or you hate. I am in the I love Makeup Revolution camp because I love Makeup Revolution. I have tried a bunch of their stuff. I have basically, I really love it. I can make it work. It's okay. And then sometimes it's just the, oh hell no. And I have two products in that category. So again, I can make most things work or I love the products. That's how I am. The first one that I'm going to mention, I don't have anymore. And that's the Conceal and Hydrate foundation. And I bought this actually because Makeup Missa raved about that foundation. Now, I think that she had very dry skin. And at that time, I had kind of normal but dehydrated skin. So I was like, you know what? Let me try it. Yeah, no. That foundation kept sliding on my face. I tried it without primer. I tried it with different sunscreens underneath. It didn't matter what I used underneath. It kept sliding around. And then if I didn't want to have it sliding around, I had to powder it really, really, really quickly. But still, I could feel that when I was setting it, it kept moving around. I needed to use so much powder that I was a cake face. It emphasized every pore, every line that I have in my face. So then I was like, you know what? Maybe I need to try the powder before foundation method. And that was a little bit better. But still, the only thing I liked about that foundation was that it had a pump. That was the only thing. But for the rest, and I really tried it. It was, no. No, maybe if you are young and if you have very dry skin, you will like it. But no. Then the next product that I have, I still have here because I still kind of want to try it out once every while. And it is actually a newer product from them. This is their under eye setting powder. And I love how the component looks. It's just a white powder. I actually tried it again just before I sat down to film because I was like, maybe, you know what it does? I actually need to put this in my special effects kit because it sucks the life right out of my face. They say this is an under eye setting powder. If I use it on my under eyes, I don't. I kind of have a little bit of dark circles here, but this brings it out. It sucks all the moisture that I have right out, and it just. So my under eye area is normal. It's not dry. I remember the first time that I tried this, I could see my skin doing heep. That's not really what you want now, is it? Or at least I know. So I am finally going to just chuck this with my special effects makeup because then, especially with my go-to Halloween-y look, I kind of want to look like a dehydrated zombie, so then this is perfect. But yeah, no. No, I kind of felt like those souls from, is it Hercules? Or is it The Little Mermaid? It's those, that's what I felt like. Yeah, I'm very dramatic today. Let's next go to a product that a lot of people loved, and I just really, really did not. And I tried it, but I love the brand so much. It's from Kaleidos, and it's their original lip stains. I had from the original three that they launched, I had one shade. I don't remember the shade, but there was just something about that formula that I really did not like. There was, I don't know how to explain it. I don't know how, there was just a certain, when I put it on my lips, there was a certain stick that I tried it. I really, really tried it. I did declutter it. And before I decluttered it, I tried it again. And I was like,
no, it's just no.
I love their lip glaze though. But that one, oh no. No, 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 no. Then I'm going to go to lip stains that I have here. And you may say, but maybe you're not a lip stain person. Yeah, it's not my favorite formula, but I do have lip stains here that I can vibe with. Let's just say that. The next ones that I don't like, Are these from Odin's Eye? Yeah. There is a way that I can get them likable-ish. I have the shade Ripe Papaya and I have the shade Perfect Plum. Now, Ripe Papaya, I love the color of. The way that I can kind of make them less nasty for me is by putting it on and then immediately blotting it with my finger, letting that dry, and then maybe blot a little bit more and then put a gloss on top. Because there is just something about a lip stain that, yeah, apparently does not agree with me. And this is a lip stain that is a little bit thicker. And that was the same way with the Kaleidos one. They are a little bit thicker. And there is just then something about the formula that I'm like... But because I really like these colors, that is the reason that they are still here. But I don't like using them at all. No, yeah, what can I say? And it's sad to say, but I really love Odin's Eye. But yeah, it's just, no. The lip stains that I do have a lip stain that I like, and that one is from Essence. And that is a thinner formula. And that kind of... There is a certain feeling when you put on a lip stain. I cannot explain it for the life of me, but there is a certain feeling. The one from Essence has it the least and it dissipates the quickest. It's still not really my favorite, but I can live with that formula. Yeah, maybe I'm just not a lip stain person. I think that is it. Maybe if I can kind of get on board with it if it's in a gloss. And then they have that staining component in a gloss as well. That I do. I have some of those. And those I really like. It's just a lip stain formula that... No. Then I'm going to go to... The next two products I don't have anymore. And I'm going to go to BH Cosmetics first. The product that I did not like from BH Cosmetics was their foundation. And I have had their foundation. And I have used the foundation... That formula, I don't even know if they still sell it. I think they do, but the formula is very... It's a thicker formula, which I don't really like, but okay. But there was just some kind of a pastiness that was in that formula that I detested with a passion. I have used the formula, or I've used the foundation, because for a long time it was my lightest foundation, so I basically then used it around Halloween-y time, but it was always... I really did not want to use that foundation. I don't have that foundation anymore. It was just that formula. No, I kind of hope, because they are revamping a lot of things, I kind of hope that they will reformulate their foundation, and then I kind of want to try it again. Also, I actually don't know if they had an olive shade then. But yeah, I really did not like that formula. No.
No.
Let's next go to the last thing that I have, and it's also from a brand I love, but this product, I tried it once and I was like, no. I really do not like you. I honestly dislike that product so much that I even did not give it away to someone else. And I feel so bad because I truly love the brand. I got the product in PR to try. I really did not like it. And that was from 5050 Makeup, and that was their brow pomade. Now, I have to say, I have tried some brow pomades and it is not my thing. For me, it was... It felt like I put Nutella in my brows. That was kind of the consistency. So the brow pomades that I have tried were a little bit more on the almost the same consistency as the gel pots from ColourPop. Drier, but still creamy. They would set, but this one was, I almost want to say, it had too much butter in it. It was too creamy for me. And when I put it... No. I really, really did not like that product. But again, I don't like brow pomades that much anyway. So it's just not up to me, you know. And I think that's with all this. With the exception of the Essence Primer. I don't know who will like that one. That was everything. Yeah, those were all the products that I really do not like from brands I really, really love. Yeah, let me know some of your bad products that you have from your favorite brands, because I'm very, very curious. And if you are a creator, go do the video, because it's just so fun to really unapologetically bitch about makeup. I usually don't do that, so I hope that you appreciated the bitchy me today. Let me know if you also want me to do the opposite, so 10 products that I love from brands that I don't like. And I'm going to make that happen anyway. I also want to film my Holy Grail products. So yeah, let me know if you are excited about that as well. And yeah, that was it for me today. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.